What do you think the answer is to this question? Can one single cell have two different custom formats? Answer is yes. It could even have more. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to create this mini dynamic report where the user can select between total sales and the number of apps. Do you notice a difference here? Same cell, formatted differently depending on the selection. Here's our sample dataset. We have a list of apps and their sales numbers. Now on the report tab, that's where we're going to be creating our mini report. So first, let's start by inserting a drop-down list. We can do that from the data tab, data validation, list. For source, we can either reference cells where we've already input our text before, or we can input in here directly. So I'm just going to directly type in total sales and count of apps. These are the two choices that we're giving the user, and right below it, that's where we're going to have the values. This is the cell that we want to conditionally format. Now, I can't custom format this because if I right mouse click, go to format cells, or use the shortcut key Control-1, I can decide on the formatting that I want, but that's going to be specific to the cell. It's not going to depend on the condition. The only conditions you can influence here is how you want positive, negative, zero, and text values to be formatted. But I can't influence this based on the value of another cell. But what I can do instead is to use conditional formatting. But before I jump ahead, let's first get our numbers in here. The if function works great in this case. Our logical test is going to look at C4 and see if C4 equals, then you can use either total sales or count of apps. I'm just going to go with total sales right now. Then what should it show if it is total sales? Well, it should show the sum of my sales column in here. So I'm going to press Control Shift down. Now I don't necessarily need to fix these because I'm not planning to pull my formula down. The next argument is if it's false, so if it's not total sales, well, if it's not, then it must be the count of apps. So I'm going to count the apps. Now, do I need count or count A? Well, that depends which column I'm planning to select. Let's say I do want to count the apps regardless if they had no sales or zero sales. I need to use count A because the difference between count A and count is that count A also counts cells that have text in them. So start off with A3, Control Shift down, close bracket again, and press Enter. So that's our total sales number. Now when I switch to count of apps, I get 27. So if you have more choices and you want to use the if function, you just need to add more ifs. And I have a more detailed video on the if formula. I'll put the link to it in the cards and in the description below. Now comes the tricky part. How do we conditionally format this so that we get the currency when we select total sales? Well, let's go and try it in conditional formatting, new rule. Now, one option that works good in this case is to use a formula, because when we're in this cell, we can use a formula to check the value in C4. And if that value equals total sales, we can format it the way we want. So I'm going to directly click on C4 and say, is this equal to total sales? And if it is, how do I want this to be formatted? Let's go to format, number, currency. I'm good with the dollar sign. I don't want to see in this case any decimal places, and I'm going to go with okay and okay. I guess I get my currency in there, I get the thousand separator in there, and when I switch to count of apps, I don't see the currency in there, which is what I want, but what I also want is to show this in bold. So I'm gonna actually change the cell formatting, so the cell style, to bold. But check this out, when I switch back to total sales, it's bold. And let's say in this case, I don't want this to be bold. I just want it to be bold when I select count. What it seems like doing is that it's taking over this bold style. Now let's go back to conditional formatting, and instead of new rule, we're going to manage our existing rule. I'm going to go to edit. Let's go to format options, and under font here, I haven't specified any font style. So now I am actually going to specify it to regular. Say okay, okay, okay. And now I don't see it in bold anymore. Only when I switch back to count of apps, I'm going to see that style. I mean, the style is bold. So if you switch to total sales, you notice that the sales style is bold, but it's being overwritten by the conditional formatting that I've defined in here. Now let's take this one step further and make it more dynamic. So I'm planning to add new apps to this. And as I do that, I want my formula to expand automatically. So I want to see the updated values without me going back and updating the range. So what I'm going to do is to turn this data set into an official Excel table. Just click anywhere inside and press Control T. Table has headers. I'm going to go with OK. I'm just going to go and clear the table style just to go back to my own table style. Now you can change the table name in here as well, but notice what happens when I add to this list. So I'm just going to add new app here. I'm going to add some really big number so that we can easily tell on the report side. Notice my total sales changed and my range here updated automatically. If I switch to count of apps, I see the updated number. So all I did there was to turn my original data set into a table. Now, obviously you can do this at the beginning before you start to write your formula, then you're likely to have the table references inside your formula, or you can do it like I did at the end. Okay, but that's how you can change the formatting of a specific cell based on a criteria. Now you can make this more complex. You could have more KPIs, different formats, have percentages or dates. Just remember, you can use conditional formatting to get the job done. So give the video a thumbs up if you liked it and press the subscribe button if you'd like to get updates when new videos come out.